Chakratunda Mahakaya Suryakoti Samaprabha Nirvignam Kurume Devam Sarvakaryeshu Sarvada Om Shri Mahaganapataye Namaha Saraswati Namastupyam Varate Kamarupini Vidyarambham Karishyami Siddhir Bhavatu Me Sada Om Shri Mahasaraswatyai Namaha Gurur Brahma Gurur Vishnu Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha Guru Sakshat Parabrahma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Om Shri Chinmaya Sadgurave Namaha Today's topic, harmony in relationships. Most difficult. Do you all agree? Relationships, we are talking with people, with things. Two things in the world, right? Living beings and non-living. So we have relationships with things and beings. These are the two things. Things are not that much of a problem sometimes, isn't it? That is why HR department in every has to be powerful, you know, to deal with machines. It's okay. They are in a way predictable. Nowadays even computers are moody. You find a lot. And then computers don't match with each other. Have you heard of that? They call it incompatible. Computers are incompatible with each other. How do you think human beings will become compatible with each other? Just imagine. Are you aware of that or not? One USB port doesn't fit into. Have you had these things happening? Wo ye USB port is computer mein nahi chalega. Are? To main kitne leke ghumu? Hota hai ki nahi aap log ko? Do you all have these? And then computers become moody, they crash, they, like how human beings, you know. So machines, it's a different thing altogether, but we right now are talking about harmony in human relationships. Things with living beings. Now, the first thing is, until and unless I am harmonious within, I will keep on creating disharmony outside. They say there are three types of people in the world. One, who are problem solvers. Second, who are problem creators. And third, who are themselves problems. You understand? They are problems. We all have a knack. We have what is called the Midas touch. You heard about the Midas touch? Whatever he touched became gold. So we also have a special touch. Whatever we touch becomes problem and conflict. Till that time, everything is fine. You come. Once one person in an office, you know, the boss told the employee, he said, how come you create so many problems? What is the rahasya behind it? How do you manage to create so many problems? You know? In the daytime, full day, the wife also tells me problems you create. In the office also you create problems. How do you manage to create so much in one day? He says, I get up early. So I have more time to create problems. Wherever I go, every minute I can create a problem. So the first thing about harmony is what? That I myself have to become what? Within. Within me, if there is harmony, then only I will be to some extent. Then also it's not guaranteed the outside I can have harmony. But if I am not harmonious within, then the chances of me having harmony outside is not much. Have you got this point? I'm a problem inside. I have lots and lots of issues which are unresolved, which are agitating me, which are making me, you know. And then if I go out and I think I'm going to create harmonious relations with people, that's not going to be possible at all. Have you got this point? And therefore, last time, if you remember, that last time's topic was very important for continuing with this time's topic. What was that? Handling emotions. But we talked about four levels of our existence. The physical, the, come on, emotional, the intellectual, and the spiritual. We actually talked about just the first two. And as we said, each one has its own specific needs. And if that need is satisfied, I have harmony at that level. For example, for the physical, we need roti, kapda, makan. But we also need what? Work. And if I have that, then physically I am fit. Okay? There's harmony in my relationship. Vata, pitta, kapha are all fine. You know? So I'm like, okay, fit. At the emotional level, if I get my quota of love and I give my quota of love, it's my need. It's not an option. It's a need. And if I don't get that, I become insecure, I become dependent, I become clinging, I become emotionally imbalanced, fear, full of fear, full of anxiety, etc., etc. We talked loneliness, all these type of things start happening. So if I am emotionally balanced, then what happens? At least at that level, then the third is what? At the intellectual level. At the intellectual level, all of us, what is our need, our basic need at the intellectual level? All of us need, what is the food at the intellectual level? Is good thoughts. The intellect survives on thoughts. And if I don't get those good thoughts, believe me, supposing I'm very hungry and I don't get food, okay? Then what will I do? And I need food because I just have to fill my stomach. So what will I do? I will eat garbage, but I will eat because I need. I will eat junk, I will eat anything that's available because I want food. I want to fill my stomach, right? Similarly, at the intellectual level, if I don't get good thoughts, what will I do? What will I do? I will survive on bad thoughts. Have you got this? I will, because I need thoughts. And I tell you, people don't understand this. See, the human intellect is such a powerful instrument. It's made with what capacities, unbelievable capacities. You think this instrument is only meant to, you know, to think this sort of thing, ke ajesu khau che, batakanu shak ke kandanu shak. And if you use it only for that much, then the rest of the intellectual power, what will it do? What? Idle mind? That's what. And that is what happens. Intellectual frustration is one of the biggest problems. Is it true or not? And what happens? Because this intellect needs food. It needs something, something all the time. It needs to munch on things. You know? And you don't give him the right thoughts, then what happens? And I tell you, to do wrong work requires more buddhi than to do the right thing. Yes or no? Chori karne mein kitni ye lagti hai, buddhi lagti hai, aise karna chahiye, aise to pakadane jaye, ye do this, don't do this. You need a lot of buddhi. So what happens? You do wrong things. Because you can't live without thinking. You want that. Have you got this point? So if you don't give it the right type of food, the right, and I tell you, a lot of people, they are intellectually frustrated. They have their own, you know, their intellect, because they have taken professions because of so many reasons. Scope achha hai. This is a typical thing they say. Scope achha hai. That is why we've taken a profession. There your buddhi doesn't work at all. Because it's not your cup of tea. Your buddhi is not meant for that. Now, the job at hand doesn't really, you know, your intellectual powers are not being used there. Then what will you do? You'll use it in, have you got it? I remember when the Harshad Mehta boom was there, I was in Ahmedabad at that time. And everyone, ISRO is busy doing what? Trading. Are abadu a rocket upar mukane badle? How kam chalte tu, you know that? Everyone, all lines are clogged, everyone is into, hey, you're a scientist, you use your buddhi in that, na? And what happened? What? You understand? This is it. your buddhi, if your buddhi, and I tell you, see, you need not know a person's background at all. If that person is gossiping, you understand too much of gossiping, understand that this person is intellectually frustrated. Have you understood? Why? Because you're surviving on crap, on dirt, on nonsense. Why? You don't have good food, then you want to know. Ani chokri koni sath bhagi gayi thi, en su kare tu, emna gare sukhan banave chhe, aapke mam kare chhe. Why? Because if you get good food, you don't want all this. You can't like it, because it's nonsense. You got my point? Intellectual frustration, and then what do? I'm stressed out. I'm stressed out doing nothing. So what do? You want that intellect to keep quiet, otherwise it'll eat you up. Right or wrong? So you want to dullen that intellect, you want to make it. Yeah. And the glory of the human being is that he has an intellect which discriminates, which thinks, which can take you to any heights imaginable. And what do you and I do? We dullen it. By the type of entertainment we do, by the type of inputs we have, we dullen the most beautiful instrument that the good old Lord has given to us. We dullen that thing. And what happens? Next day morning, hangover. And with that mind, you want to face the world. What harmony can you create? Have you got the point? Yes? This instrument, this most fantastic instrument called the intellect, should always be, you know, in the good old days, they used to have this, barbers, they used to have that big, huge, and? Razor nahi ke vayne, ustro, astro. It used to be one big, I don't know how you all had the guts to go and sit there with that big, huge. And, see, when there's no customer, what will he do? When there's no customer, what will he do? He would have a stone and a little this water and he would put it on. And then, koi aave, aaja. And then you go and he shaves you or whatever. You get it? So all the time this instrument is kept what? This is exactly what one should do with the intellect. It should be alert. It should be available. It should be absolutely trim and perfect. And right now all our entertainment, all our eating habits, our entire lifestyle only makes it dull. Is it a fact or not? You see, watch three movies, Dham, Doom, HBO and all that thing, and then by the end... In fact, if you switch off your intellect only, you can watch half the movies, especially the Hindi ones. Is it true or not? If you keep it on, you just can't watch it. You know, people used to tell me, Swamiji, aap picture bo fine cha, aap picture bo fine cha. The neighbor can help out, you know. It's good to help others. Okay, fine. That's why I do all these exercises, you know. We should be alert. Right. So what I'm saying is that this most beautiful, fantastic instrument, which can take us to any heights, it is the best thing that the good Lord has done. It's given, Bhagwan gave us an intellect which can decide, which can make choices, which can... Kartum shakyam, akartum shakyam. It can do, it can do, not do, it can do. Otherwise, all innovations, all inventions, all creativity, everything is possible because you and I have this most beautiful instrument called the intellect. Is it true or not? I told you it's the one that gives direction. It's the one that gives you what? Direction. The emotions give you the power, but it's the intellect that gives you the what? Directions. Unfortunately, the intellect is not fit. We don't know how to use it. It doesn't know how to give directions or it doesn't know how to work itself. There was a very nice story of this man who went to the his nephew's place in the city. He was from the village, small village. And then there's this car. He had seen the car, but he had never sat in it. So he sat in the car and the nephew took him around and all. And Jara, he was showing off, okay, you know, showing off. And what happened? The car skidded on the road and there was a tree on the side and it banged on the tree. So the kaka was unfazed. He was very carefully watching this young boy, you know, as he was driving. So the nephew was scared because accident at the end of the day, even though no one was hurt, he was just shaken up, completely shaking. And he says, Kakaji, are you all right? Everything all right? No, Kakaji said, absolutely fine. Why are you looking so scared? So he's saying, I have been the last half an hour, I saw how you were, you know, how you started the car, how you were steering it, how you changed gears and all. Last half an hour, I was wondering how you would stop it. Now I know. What should you do? Whenever you want to stop the car, find a tree. That is called an accident. That's not called a... Yes. So therefore, this intellect of ours, you know, how it can steer us, when it has to stop, when it has to go, what speed it should go, this all should be in our hand. Is it true or not? The entire instrument of ours, the body, the intellect is the one that can do all of that. Okay? And that... So what happens? Very, very important instrument is the intellect. And that aspect, as I said, if it's not satisfied, it doesn't get good thoughts, then it, what happens? It survives on bad thoughts. Either it gets, you know, if I have 10 rupees and I spend 5 rupees, how much do I have? 5. Now this is the principle that most people use for their intellect. Okay, atli chhe ne vapli vapru to. It doesn't work that way. It works differently. The more you use, so as we grow old, this should become sharper and better, or it should become duller. And what happens? Why? Either it's misused or not used. Will you remember this? Will you remember? Either it's not used or it is misused. Either way, it will become not usable. So we need to see that it is constantly... Okay, fine. Then, of course, there is the spiritual level. Now, what is at the spiritual level, what is my need? See, at the end of the day, I may have everything. I may have food, I may have, you know, emotionally satisfaction, and intellectually, I am quite happy, I'm not frustrated. Yet, at the end of the day, you will ask this question, what is the meaning to life? Is it true or not? After all, why am I living? What is the purpose? Why did God make the world? What is the reason? Why a human being? What happens after I die? Why is there sorrow in the world? Do these questions come to you or not? Yes or no? At the end, what have I achieved which I can call it's my? What have I done? These sort of questions are your spiritual needs. Normally when these questions come, now you get so shaken up, what do you do? Hey, chalo chai peete rahe. Let's try and forget it because it shakes you up. You say, well, how will I do? Or you ring up someone and say, chalo na apne picture jo ajaiye. You don't want to face these questions. But this is your spiritual need. And sometime or the other, in some way or the other, it comes up. Right? You need to have some meaning to life. Do you agree with me? That meaning to life is given, it is your spiritual need. And you have to satisfy it. Otherwise, there will be a meaninglessness in life. Have you got it? Meaninglessness. And many times it happens, people get up and they don't know what to do really, so they fill their life instead of living a fulfilled life. Have you understood the difference? Savarna Sukaru, I remember, it's a very, very sad thing that happened. I felt so bad. There was one lady, she used to sleep by 9 o'clock. Elderly person, quite old. She was by 9 o'clock. I said, how many hours did you get up? She said, wow. How many hours did you get up? 9? 11 kalak of sleep at your age, jem jem umar thai tem tem ung ochi thai ke vadhe? Ochi thai. Ane aa ben to 11 kalak unge, it's like amazing. I said, you can sleep 11 hours, that's very nice. I mean, not very nice, but anyway. So, she says, nahi Swamiji, be vage aank to khuli jaye. What? 9 to 2, good enough, you know, you've slept your bit of it, now what more? And you haven't really worked that hard anyway in the daytime. So what, 9 to 2, your aankh to khuli jaye. I said, what do you do then? He says, soon kare, itle padi rahu. Now see, it is such a, I don't know whether you realize what a sad, I almost cried that day. I said, what a sad thing. The human life, the most precious, the most durlabh, and the manushya deha, the most precious life in the whole of this universe is not no guarantee that the next lifetime is going to be a human lifetime. And what do? You are wasting it body wrong because I don't know what to do when I get up. What a sad story. Is it true or not? What? How? So many people are like that. They don't know what. You ask people, what is the goal of your life? They give you a professional goal. Most of them say, I want to become an engineer, I want to become a doctor, I want to. When you ask young people, what do they say? They just say that. I want to be. They haven't even thought of it. I ask them, what do you want to become? I want to become a doctor. So if becoming a doctor is the goal of your life, then the day you become a doctor, you should die. Have you got the point or not? Because you've achieved the goal of your life. But do you die? Do you want to die? Then what's the goal of? I'm not asking you a professional goal. I'm asking you the goal of your life. Have you understood the difference? No one has thought of it. Why are you living? Someone said, because I'm not dying. That's all. Such a meaninglessness to life. You understand that? I remember one girl telling me, I don't know whether I live to eat or eat to live. This is what happens. Especially when you grow older and older, you find that everything is marked by the next meal. Uthine, what is the next big event? Breakfast. After that, what is the next big event? Lunch. After lunch, what's the next big event? You understand? That's the next big event, nothing else. What do you mark your life? And a lot of business also happens like that, no, over lunch, after tea, in tea, with tea. Is it true or not? Everything is marked by food. That's the big thing of life, yes or no, especially for Gujaratis. So therefore, you have to have some meaning to life. Where have I come from? What am I doing? Where do I have to go? A man came into a train, the ticket checker came and said, where's your ticket? I don't have it. Are you? From where, which station did you get in? I don't know. You don't know which station you got in? Okay, which station do you want to go? I don't know. You don't know where you want to get down? Why are you in the train? I don't know. Now, what do you call a person like that? Most of us are like that. Why are we in this journey of life? Where do you want to go? Wherever it takes me. Life, let me see as it comes. Wherever. From where have I, where have you come? From which air? You get the point. Why are you living? You get the point? So this spiritual need in all of us is there. If you're a human being and if you're a thinking human being, you will want to find meaning to life. Yes or no? This is your spiritual need. So if that is satisfied, how can it get satisfied? Satsang is the way. What we're doing right now is called satsang. That is the way. And you understand so many things. You find some meaning. You find some purpose. You find some inspiration. You find some mantra which charges you and makes you live a. You shine and you outshine in life because you have some meaning to life. Okay? Now, if I can harmonize myself within, spiritually, intellectually, especially my mind and intellect, which is always seems to be at war with each other, if I can harmonize and integrate myself within, then I definitely have a better chance of living a harmonious life without. Is that okay? Now, let's talk about a few principles of harmony in relationships. Few mantras, if you please. Okay? The first principle about harmonizing relationships is, do unto others as you would have others do unto you. In Gita, it's written as, Atma upamyena sarvatra samam pasyati yorjuna sukham vayadiva dukham sayogi paramo matah. That's a Gita way of saying it. Do you want, meaning what? What do you like in life? What do you like? You like everyone to be sympathetic to you, yes or no? You like people to accept you as you are. Is it true or not? Hu jeva hou tevo, mane accept karo, right? Mara mag bhale gamme tetli bhulo hoy, accept me as. Isn't it? We don't want to say, no, you change and then you come. Then what do you say? If you don't accept me, I don't care. I am what I am. Hun badlavano nathi. Tamare je karu e te, kari lyo. Nathi? Aa badha dialogue badha ghanae ghana var gharo ma bolya hoy chhe. We want to be accepted as we are. Is it true or not? Everyone wants to be accepted as we are. Then later, fine, change can happen. But the first thing is, if you don't even accept the person as they are, see, we, you and I have no problem in accepting animals with all their swabhava as they are, dress or no. A dog will be a dog, and it will bark, and it will do whatever it does, right? So do you expect the dog to be like a cat? You don't, because a dog will be a dog, and a cat will be a cat, and you don't expect them to be otherwise, but we don't accept human beings as they are, yes or no? What do we want? And I tell you this, another foolish thing that every girl seems to have when she gets married. When they badli kadi, shh. If she really, I tell you, don't ever go with this thought. If he really loves me, are bappa, tu badlai jo ispane nahi badlashe. Guarantee. Anubhavi loko betha chke nahi bolo. Koi badlayo chhe atyar sudhi? Funny, you find so many young girls, you know. Kai vandane ene thodi kharab tev chhe, pan kai vandane, I tell you. Foolish. Don't do that, you will suffer. Okay? Either way. Oh! You think the good old missus has ever... No way. So please don't, you know, yes, when a person wants to change, the person changes. It's not that they don't. When they want to change, they change. But if you think, I am going to change everyone and I... No, first accept. Okay, this is the way it is. My nose is crooked. Fine? Now I can get a plastic surgery done and... That is possible. But first I have to accept it. When there is resistance in even accepting the person, then the relation becomes already strained. Have you understood this point? There's already a strain in relationship because you've not even seen. You say, this is it, full stop. This person whom I am supposed to live. It happens. That's one of the most beautiful things about these arranged marriages. What happens? You start with knowing that you have to, what? Adjust and accept and adjust. So what happens is you start with that. So he says, huh? And then in the good old days, so they never even had a, you didn't even see the other person really. Sometimes so, koik ne koik kare. So on the day of the wedding, when the parda goes like that, and you say, hey, this size, look at the size. My God, I have to live with this one. For God alone knows how many years of my life. You could imagine the poor girl or the boy, whichever size, you know, I mean, both the sizes can be different, you know. And you, I tell you, you know, what adjustments, is it true or not? And then you say, oh God, no. You start with that, you start with this, otherwise what, there is resistance. And nowadays what happens, people get married later and later, so they have more rigid ideas, and that person must be like that, and like that, and like that, and not like that, and like that. Only if he SMSs me 25 times a day, he means he loves. If it is 22, not enough. How funny, funny ideas, and you know, all types of ridiculous, what do you say? And then how are we going to have harmony? On what basis can you have harmony? Have you understood this? So first thing is what? You understand, I want to be accepted as I am, so does the other person. First principle is accept. What is there? And then you can do whatever else you want to do. That's a different thing. But first is you, otherwise initially only there is a resistance. For example, now here is this audience, this wonderful audience sitting over here. You all have to accept me as I am. Isn't it true? Then you are open to listening to me. Otherwise, nahi, aao kem kare chhe, aam kem betha, aam kem bole chhe, aavi rite nahi karu joe, tika tipni karo to hum je bolo to you will not be able to. There's always already a resistance, yes or no. There are always, as I told you, some people in the audience who are, that attitude. Now what happens, there's already a resistance. There is already a, yes. These are the roots of disharmony in life. Okay? So first we have to understand that everyone. And then remember this one thing. Yatha drishti tatha srishti. Okay. Are you all seeing the same hand? Come on. Say something. Yes. Are you seeing the same thing? Yes. No. Yes. You all are seeing this side of the hand. You all are seeing this side of the hand. Isn't it true? You are not seeing the same thing. You all are all seeing different. The people who are in the front are seeing something different. The people who are over here are seeing. Every one of you is seeing different, right? Not only that, you all have different powers. What is this color? Red, orange, red, something. Are you all seeing the same color? Come on. No. Someone has forgotten their specs. They can hardly see. Or someone, you understand. So you are all seeing different. Your power is different. The way the light reflects from different angles is different. So you are not seeing the same. Now you go and argue. Me joyutune, aam hatune, aam hatune, me argue. Have you understood this? Yatha drishti tatha srishti. You are seeing the world, including the people, the circumstance and things, as it is being shown to you. Have you all understood that? Yes? You are not seeing it as it is. You are seeing it as it is shown. Understand this, that there is my filter, and my filters are hundreds of filters. Yes or no? The way I have been brought up, the type of school that I have studied in, don't you think that influences? Yes. The type of family background, the type of in other friends circle, all this is influencing my way of looking at the world. And I'm seeing the world through all these filters. It happened once, you know, when I was giving my talk. At the end of the talk, one person came and said, Swamiji, I hope you don't mind, you know, but I want to tell you something. Very like, I said, yeah, what is it? He says, no, Swamiji, in your talk, you know, you made 20 grammatical mistakes. She was an English teacher, you can imagine. So she was sitting and what? Every time I made a grammatical mistake, well-meaning, nice person, wanted to, you know, improve me, which is very good, very nice, you know. So she said, you know, this is the place you make mistakes. I said, I'll try to improve, but when you give talk, now we all grammar, and we are so busy trying to communicate the idea that sometimes grammar takes a secondary role. And that is why it's possible that I make. I'll try to keep these things in mind. And as I was saying, you know, she said,